As of August 31st of 2025, there are currently 43 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is one more than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes, which I commonly highlight in my weekly news segments due to its picturesque nature, is Guatemala's Fuego volcano. While Fuego has produced larger and more destructive eruptions such as in 1974 and 2018, the vast majority of its activity is several orders of magnitude less explosive. On average, Fuego produces a volcanic explosion about once every 5 to 20 minutes, ejecting large lava bombs in a fairly wide radius, creating an ash plume, and sometimes also generating pyroclastic flows. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Alaska, the alert level was raised at the Shishaldin volcano due to potential signs of rising magma, including a far stronger degassing plume, increased earthquakes, and sulfur dioxide emissions. Meanwhile, in the Philippines, there's an increased risk of the Taal volcano erupting in the near future, as without pause, it has been producing a non-stop volcanic tremor signal since the earliest hours of August 27th. And in what is this week's top story, many reports are being spread around about the, and I am paraphrasing here, sudden appearance of smoking from Damavand's summit. For reference, the towering Damavand volcano has not erupted in approximately 7,300 years and rises to become the tallest point in the entire nation of Iran as its summit reaches an altitude of 5,610 meters or 18,406 feet. Located 65 kilometers or 40 miles east-northeast of Tehran, while this volcano does contain active fumaroles and has for some time, its summit is usually devoid of a gas plume looking like this. That is why, when earlier in the week, numerous videos were widely shared on social media that actually showed a strong rising gas plume and not smoke from Damavand's summit, it seemed highly unusual. Was Damavand, after multiple millennia of no activity, suddenly showing signs of unrest? To this I say, nope. It is true that Damavand in the last week produced a strong gas plume, but this gas plume was white in color and was almost entirely composed of water vapor. Last week, Damavand's summit region received a rare case of an August snowfall which covered an area of 1.41 square kilometers. However, this unusually thick snowfall subsequently quickly melted away due to summer temperatures, dropping to covering a mere half a kilometer, adding unusually high amounts of water vapor to the otherwise dry air. This moisture then quickly rose as a distinct white plume, giving off the incorrect appearance that Damavand was showing signs of unrest. Meanwhile, in Alaska, on August 25th, the alert level was raised at a volcano which had ceased erupting 2 years ago, rising from a color code of green to yellow. This change was made at the Shishaldin volcano, which had been showing signs of unrest for several weeks now, experiencing an elevated number of earthquakes beneath its summit. Well, during the last week, the number of these earthquakes further increased and became stronger in magnitude, occurring alongside other changes which soon followed. Infrasound sensors began picking up increased and stronger signals, with this being followed by increasing concentrations of sulfur dioxide gas. Sulfur dioxide gas is an important marker of magma at a volcano and is generally only emitted at the surface when it is present at fairly shallow depths. This all occurred alongside a stronger gas plume as seen here, so there is now a greatly increased likelihood of a volcanic eruption occurring in the next few weeks to months at this remote volcano. And in the Philippines, after a month of no eruptions occurring, a change occurred at the Taal volcano. While sulfur dioxide emissions did increase, they are still low for this volcano, but this occurred alongside an increased release of seismic energy. Mainly because since 12:12 a.m. local time on August 27th, a single non-stop volcanic tremor from Taal has been ongoing. This could be due to magma, gas, and/or fluid movement, but two of the last three times something similar occurred at Taal, it ended up producing a phreatic or phreatomagmatic eruption within a week's time of the tremor's end. Something similar could soon occur, but if an eruption did happen, it would, in my opinion, likely be small in size. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on August 30th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my YouTube channel members and patrons on Patreon for supporting my work.